in her leisure. Mary. Hi. Can we see what kind of work you're doing here? Oh yes, that's quite lovely. And, oh, look at that. There's a tent.
Mom, look at my new bike.
Hey, Paul. Your lovely campsite. Did you? Yes. What happened? Hi, guys.
Hi.
June 24th, 1998. Actually, her first day of really enjoying the pool. Haven't let her out yet. You like it. Hi, Paul. There's alligators in here. It's an 8-foot kiddie pool. Nice deck. Where's Cecilia? Stating her opinions about the water is bath water. Temperature. I think she's trying to say hi to the Giles girl. Hi,
Mom.
There's Lynn. That's good.
Excuse me, Mother. May I get my swimsuit on?
Big diagonal cut coming down the animal like this. We'll just take the whole tenderloin out. There you go, you got a little bush relay.
He got his meat and his bone. He's happy.
He got his meat, his bone, and his bush relay.
Thank you.
And the prophet as well. The gospel of the Lord. Personal thoughts and prayers, which we mentioned now
some of the Toledo game. Marianne Christine, Dick and Barbara. Back up and...
Ha ha ha. Thank you. you will join us out on the dance floor. We're MC Music with Jeff Bernay Productions, and if you have any requests, we'll be happy to play them for you. Please feel free to come on up. We love requests.
Get your grill, your...
Get your golf grill.
Come on, Mike, you did it.
Michael, oh, granddad gets credit.
You guys trying to...
I would eat the profit.
Con somebody into thinking you're modest?
So you got to work out of the
good
photo.
Stuff.
Derek, can you bring Daddy in here?
Yep, Derek's talking about it.
Hey, Peggy.
A little bit of sugar in?
Right.
A little bit of food?
You gotta finish up the tape here.
But they don't lie.
Yeah.
That's the trouble.
Oh. There's the groom, the old married man. All right, get you at the dishes, Mike.
Hey, the brother's gotta do all the work.
I tell ya, I know that routine. Now we got a couple tag ones over there. Editor's privilege. Just about out of battery here.
Bob had it, huh?
Oh, we'll get the whole tape here. There's Bob. All right. That's it for now.
Would it help if I see you at like 1 o'clock?
I'm up.
My eye, huge and ginormous.
It's huge.
Was it on, Dad?
It is on.
Thank you.
Yeah, but. Yep, if you're careful.
How you doing? People see you.
Hey, Sarah, I'll see you, honey. You.
Dad, face it at me again.
Ty, here you go, buddy.
Larry, can you see that shoe?
Yes, you may. You certainly may.
Where can we eat?
You can eat around the table up there or at the table in the corner.
I'm 7 years. August the 1st will be 7 years. I signed up for 6 more years this last year. So I got 5 more to go. Yeah, oh yeah, I don't like to change. This is my, I have my 25th anniversary.
I got to tell you.
Have a good time, Mom? Good.
Oh.
No, it's okay. You don't have to do anything different.
Cameron.
I don't know that I do. Let me check. Mom and Dad, you having a good time?
Yes.
Good.
I have to tell you that joke Father told us. Oh.
Not sure we want that recorded, though, do we?
Dad, isn't
that beautiful? Yeah, it really is something, isn't it? Tom Monahan's office. Why don't you have a seat there, Claire? I'll just take a picture of you. Ah, yes. A close-up of my dear Claire. Love you, sweetie.
Hey, everybody. This is a mitt, and it has some of the Detroit Tigers.
Great.
In 1984.
Good job. No, just a minute, sweetie. Judy.
Hi. Are you ready to start?
Yep, I'm coming right down.
Oh, my God.
Hey, Darnell, loosen up. Well, a motley crew here. We just wanted to just take a couple minutes just to mention some memories that Dan and I and some of us have. And again, if any of you have any anecdotes, feel free to pipe in. But we just thought we'd take just a little bit of time now just to reflect on some, whether it be humorous or memorable occasions from the past. And there's lots to choose from. I don't know how you boil it down to just a few minutes, but ranging from, I remember as a kid when Dad would used to play hide-and-go-seek with us, and I'll never forget hiding underneath the kitchen sink.
It had air holes in it, though.
Yeah, it had air holes in it, but, you know, I think to this day I've had a fear of closed spaces. And Mom, you know, Mom is always so happy-go-lucky. I remember she would always take us to go to Tiger baseball games on Saturdays. Saturdays when ladies' day games at Tiger Stadium. Women and kids 14 or younger got in for 50 cents. And she would just load up a car full of kids. I mean, anybody on the street, who wants to go to a baseball game? And we just be packed in the car, and we go to Tiger Stadium for a ball game. We saw Denny McClain get his 30th victory on a Saturday ladies' day home game.
And I remember that.
But there was one memorable occasion. You weren't allowed to take bottles into the stadium for fear of throwing it. And we would always smuggle in pop bottles for stuff. And I'll never forget one of the times at a ladies' day game, we were going there, and the guy that was checking, and he goes to my mom, and he looks at her point blank and says, "Lady, do you have any bottles?" And she says, "No, sir, not at all." And no sooner did she say that than a bottle falls out of her, and it just spatters all over the floor. I mean, just all over. I mean, just a blatant lie.
I just had argued with him about Danny, because he said Danny had to be 14, and Danny wasn't, you know. If you were 14, you had to pay. And he said, no, he's not. He wasn't 14. He said, "Lady, that's the biggest 13-year-old I ever saw."
Told me to stoop over on my way in.
There's this man who goes to his lawyer. He's been married for 50 years. And he goes up to his lawyer and he says, "I want you to get me a divorce." And the guy says, "Why do you want a divorce after 50 years of being married?" The guy looks at him and says, "Tell you, enough is enough." I guess you can't help but feel that way. Some of the times you're going to get to 50 years of marriage, but fortunately, there's been more than enough of good of love and sharing and good times. And I remember a lot of those good times. There's been a lot of connection, a lot of family activity that stay in my memory that was part of our household. A lot of the card games, you know, remember Dad and Mom and all the uncles and Grandpa playing pinochle, and Grandpa getting real into it.
My dad used to think of it terrible. My dad never played cards. I'm glad I don't play cards.
But Grandpa Darnell would get a bad hand, and he'd take the cards and rip them up and flush them down the toilet. And all the times they're sort of getting together at everybody's houses, you know, people come over to our house, and go over to Uncle Glenn's, to Larry's, to Jeff's house. Jungle Gym there, we go out to Camp Dearborn, we go to Uncle Jimmy's, Aunt Donna's house, and play baseball at the field across the way.
Yeah.
I remember one time sliding into second base, and you were there to call, the throw was there, the ball was right there, well ahead of me, I got tagged out, Uncle Jimmy was there saying, "Safe."
Beautiful.
Those are the kind of things I remember, a lot of good memories, a lot of activity.
That one. And I remember going to Cedar Point in Uncle Jeff's station wagon and a couple of us sticking our feet out the back window on the way back. Great memories of that. They tend to teach me to play golf. I mean, you've got to understand my dad's love of golf. And whenever we would go to for a driving lane. Ken, do this, do that. Shut up! God only knows how good a golfer I could have been. But actually, in truth, he has given me a love for the game, and I'm very grateful and thankful for that. I really appreciate that, Dad. And, he was invested in it. You know, I'd go golfing with Dad more recently, and he wouldn't play, but he'd just walk right along. And we'd get on the green, and I'm ready to putt, and he's going like this, or like that, trying to read the green, telling me which way it's going to go, you know. It's just memorable times. I remember also with Mom. Mom is frugal. If any of you don't know my mom, my goodness. I remember one time she sent me to get pizza for dinner, and so I was a little kid at the time. And I went to get the pizza. She gave me the money, and I came back, and it was the wrong amount of change. I got short change, 57 cents or whatever. No, so my mom came back with me to the pizza store and demanded the money back. That is short. And the guy said, "Come on, lady. I mean, the kid could have kept it himself." Oh man, it's like a mama bear. He's really irate. Her son pocketing the money. Well, no, she said, "No, I want the money. I want you to correct it now." And the guy said, "Well, lady, it's the middle of business. I'd have to close the register and recount it." She says, "I can wait." Finally, the guy says, "Okay, I'll give it to you." I mean, all said and done, that was probably 30-some years ago, and with interest, it might have amounted to $4.75. But I remember that clue.
I remember when I must have just been 4 or 5 years old. She gave me a note to take to the butcher store, which was about a half a mile away along Warren Avenue. I had to cross all these streets to get there. I couldn't even remember what it was I was supposed to get, but she'd have to give me a note. And it was always a great adventure for me, because the biggest part of the adventure was seeing if I could get back home before I had to use the bathroom. So my mom had confidence in me. Only once did I fail her.
A couple of things that also stick out in my mind about my folks is education was always important to them. And God bless them. They really wanted to have Dan and me have more opportunities than they did to have. And I marvel at the amount of sacrifice that they took to send us to private all-guys school and stuff. And some of my best friendships I still have to this day from that high school. And apart from that, just the integrity and the character of the teachers and stuff will be with me forever. And I'm forever grateful for their commitment to Dan and myself in terms of really getting an education.
I always wanted to get the
cops. But as Dan was mentioning, just a lot of fond memories about vacation times, extended family times. I mean, whenever you got a bunch of Darnells together, a bunch of Yahoos, you know, and you had all the cousins in to boot, and well, we just had a great time, you know. And I know as everybody got older, I know personally, I know that's true for Dan too. We just look forward to family get-togethers with the Darnells. You know, it's a family that really loved each other and cared about each other. And you know, one of the last things I wanted to say is that Mom and Dad, you're survivors. You know, you're survivors in a good sense. I mean, 50 years of marriage, that means there's a lot of good and there's a lot of bad. And you think about the in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, but we've had it all, you know, in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. And I'm grateful for your commitment and your loyalty, and I love you all.
Thank you, Ken.
Shut up. Most of that is attributed to your very hard work and your dedication to bring him up, right, which I appreciate. But I also just appreciate you guys welcoming me into your family. You have always just said, "I love my daughters-in-law. They're just part of my family." There has never, on my part, been any in-law conflict, and I am surrounded by a lot of friends who have a lot of in-law conflicts. I'm very thankful that I just don't experience that with you at all. And I also just wanted to thank you for being excellent, excellent grandparents. My kids all really, I mean, we all love you, but our kids all really love you. Even, you know, you're a richer tooth fairy than we are, so they appreciate what you put under the pillow more than what I do. But those were just three
things that I wanted to just thank you that I have never actually thanked you for just all your love and kindness. And
I've always loved that.
Grandpa, the other day, as I was sitting in the living room, he said, "Annette, I pray for you every day." And I said, "You do?" And I had heard this before, but somehow it struck me more. He said, "I had surgery 7 years ago," and he said, "Every day I pray that you won't have more problems." And it always struck me that every day for 7 years is a long time for somebody to do that.
Anyway, this is a great time. And Bob, we're proud of you, buddy. Hanging. And you too, Dolores. And by the way, the Pope is still in the city. First line.
Okay, guys. It's the press conference. What do you have to say to the National Enquirer?
What do we have to say
to the National Enquirer?
Jeez. Act as if you liked one another.
That's right.
So far apart.
Hey, it is a 50th anniversary, you know.
Uncle John.
That's right. Thank you.
Paul, you can be replaced.
She's good at that, Uncle Jimmy.
Can you fit? Hold me up, everybody.
Hi.
Look
at her. She's prettier.
I'll vouch for that.
Hi. Cast a thousand. Betty, Alice, Aunt Donna, Dolores, Holly, and Stella. Yeah.
REC.
Yeah, but I don't want to read all.
Okay, then true.
I got it. Hey, Judy, smile. You're on candid camera.
Hi.
Lady, you're on candid camera.
Hi.
Congratulations.
Hey. No, okay, guys, just turn that off now.
Hi, guys. I hope they aren't taking it on the list somewhere.
They're upstairs.
Dad, what do you want? I mean, what kind of pizza do you want?
He'll eat the cheese.
Yeah, one topping tea like that. Like we got, I was wondering about something
that
a few more toppings and kind of more vegetarian pizza.
I'm really interested because anything and everything.
Well, Annette, will you order it, please? Everybody's conscious. I mean,
you know what?
We've got three pizzas to choose from.
So we are at Plymouth Park in Michigan, and we're all planning for a pair game. The plan being it, I think. Yes, we know Ken can count. For the best reader at our table.
Oh,
and they There are all the jailbirds. There's Dan guarding the jail. And there's Ken, Mr. Pig, and everybody seems to be free. Hi, Dan. Sarah's in jail trying to... Claire's out. Sarah's in. In the jail, these two girls. I'll free you. Hang on. Okay, you're free. Go. Sneak out that way. Everybody poops from the game. Waiting for their drink. This is Ty.
This is part of the reception at Mary's confirmation.
Oh, it's a circle.
Uncle Pat just left.
Colette, show Daddy your dress. Oh. Show Daddy your dress.
Oh, my God. What is that?
Flowers? Whoa. That was a pop balloon.
That's a pop balloon?
Yo, wait, wait. Put it in the garbage.
Oh, you have a little lady.
All right, now the mom's call.
Oh, it's David.
Show Daddy your shoes.
What are you doing? Huh? There's Sarah here too. It's amazing David isn't jumping all over you now too. You know that Mr. Witty's a grandfather now? Colette? Mr. Witty's a grandfather now. Dave, what are you doing? All right. Second round coming through here.
What are you guys looking for?
Look at my arm.
Ooh, what did you find?
Yeah.
Very cool. Where did you find that?
In a tree.
Wow. Oh, you just trimmed them back?
Yeah, we trimmed them.
Yeah. David just got three shots. Hey, Dave, you should come on home, okay? That's all right. That's all right. It was good to see you play it.
Yeah.
How old are you now?
Seven.
What's today? May 11th. It's Uncle Pat's birthday.
Yep.
All right. Okay. Come on, what you doing? Okay, Mary gets to go next. Just the one for now.
Mm-hmm.
second one. But don't write on the thing. But where's your princess? Get your princess on and come right back. Get the princess on and come right back, quick.
The Jolly Miller. Very nice, honey. Thank you.
Okay, say good night.
Good night.
Look at Daddy. Look at Daddy. Look at Daddy. Smile. Okay, play. Don't write down anything. Just play the keys so I can put it on the camera.
Thank you.
Smile.
I got it.
Okay, camera's running out of battery. What? It's almost out of the battery. It's gonna stop. Say bye.
Bye.
Look at the camera and say bye.
Bye, camera.
And say bye. Say goodnight, Daddy.
Goodnight, Daddy.
Say I love you.
I love you.
Say my name is Colette. I'm 2 years old.
I'm
10 years old. And I got a shot tonight.
I got a shot tonight.
How many shots did you get?
I got 10.
Just one shot.
Just one shot.
For chicken pox.
And chicken pox.
Say, I love you.
I love you.
Say bye.
Bye.
What are you girls doing?
Singing.
How old are you? Look at those curls.
Come on. Right now. We're gonna go pee. We're gonna go.
That's not
our. Well, you know, posterity and all.
I think I would take it. I'm French Canadian.
Let me zoom in on that comment. What was that?
She said hi. I did that picture there.
We got tonight, and one of the things that we've enjoyed doing throughout the year during our circle time, which most of the kids really love participating in, is called bear hunt. So we're going to do a bear hunt for you tonight. Animals besides bears. So I have to find out what animal we're hunting for tonight. Okay, anybody want to tell me what animal they
Outside, the wind blew the leaves through the trees. The leaves fell on the roof. The tea kettle whistled. Ooh, annoying, said Peter. Peter went to see the wise man in the village. What can I do? Peter asked the wise man. My house makes too much noise. My bed creaks. My floor squeaks. The wind blows the leaves through the tree. The leaves fall on the roof, swish, swish. My tea kettle whistles, hiss, hiss. I can help you, the wise man said. I know what you can do. But, said Peter, get a cow, said the wise man. What good is a cow, said Peter. But Peter got a cow, anyhow. Donkey, said the wise man. What good is a donkey? Said Peter. But Peter got a donkey anyhow. Went back to the wise man. Get a sheep, said the wise man. What good is a sheep? Said Peter. But Peter got a sheep anyhow. And he went back to the wise man. Get a hen, said the wise man. What good is a hen? Said Peter. But Peter got a hen anyhow. Thank you.
too. As good as a dog, said Peter, or a cat. But Peter got a dog and a cat anyhow. Went to the wise man. I told you my house was too noisy, he said. I told you my bed creaks, my floor squeaks, the leaves fall on the roof a swish swish, the tea kettle whistles hiss hiss. You told me to get a cow. All day the cow says moo, moo. You told me to get a donkey. All day the donkey says, Peter. You told me to get a sheep. All day the sheep says, baa, baa. You told me to get a hen. All day the hen says, baa. You told me to get a dog and a cat. All day the dog says, woof, woof. All day the cat says, meow, meow. I'm going crazy. Let the cow go, let the donkey go, let the sheep go, let the hen go, let the dog go, let the cat go. So Peter let the cow go. He let the donkey go. He let the sheep go. He let the hen go. He let the dog go. He let the cat go. Now no cow said moo. No donkey said meow. No sheep said baa. No hen said baa. No dog said woof. No cat said meow. The bed creaked.
Peekaboo. Peekaboo. Yeah. You like that, huh? You're giving me one of those cheesy grins?
She can talk, but she doesn't want to.
I know. We just had her dinner. Come on.
Thank you.
behind her head is a big sharp outlet. And I don't want her to pull back and bang her head in. No, that's not the kind of playing we're going to do right now. Okay, scoot down towards the middle, Colette. Okay, all of you, get in bed.
Important stuff. And, yeah, what else is it?
Get in bed. Get in bed. Babe.
He's fixing it, Dad. Got some sugar and a cream.
Colette, get in bed. Dave, can you turn off that light over there? Nope. Get in bed. Get in bed. How about turning off on that one in the corner over there, Vicky? Yeah. You can turn that off, Dave. Okay, get in bed. Lay down, Cece. Their little apartment. Mary and Joe are over at, or Joe and Paul are at Uncle Alex's, and Mary and Annie are at grandmother's.
No words. No words.
Warm bath after the ocean.
Yeah.
And David? Yep. We had to get the sand out of our suits and. And Daddy? Did you ride the waves, Daddy?
Daddy got smacked around carrying the children in the waves.
Was it fun?
Mary smacked me when she got caught in the wave.
Oh, really?
In the face.
She got thrown into you?
Yeah.
Oh, fun. Oh, that's fun. That's fun. Well, this is Ocean City. This is our little apartment here. We've got our own kitchen.
Yes,
got all this over here. A couple of double beds and then a couch area that opens up too. Coco trying to get VeggieTales to work. Hi, Coco. You can't get VeggieTales to work? Why not? All right, I'll help you. Coco's being cute too, Dad. What are you doing? Oh, it's hard not being the baby anymore. This is the living room.
Let come here.
In our hotel.
No, Mary, no.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi. Let come here. Sit down. Let me take a picture.
Hi, Colette.
This is vacation.
Hi.
Are you having a fun time? Where did you have have for dinner?
Broccoli
and french fries. You didn't have broccoli. Wait, hang on, I've got to get Cece. Where's Cece? Children, did you guys all have a nice dinner? David, what was the high point of your day? Turn around. No, what was the most fun thing? What's the first, the thing you just never did before in your whole life and you did it today? What'd you do? That was fun. I'm glad to see that you're alive and well and living to tell about it. That's great. And how old are you, sir? Five. Sorry, I didn't mean to bore you. Sometimes I want to. Did you three over there have a nice time?
Yes.
Swimming in the ocean?
Yes.
Having a blast?
Can we have a nice fucking
boat? Paul, do you have something to say? Hi, did you like being smashed about by the waves of the ocean too?
Oh,
yeah,
not
so. Isn't it yum?
Mom, I
don't
know.
It would have been yum for Grandma.
Not you, seven? Good, I wondered.
Yeah, Grandma would like it. Mom, Grandma loves
not. She just likes to try other people's bathrooms.
What did you do with this? All you have to do is this.
What?
Oh, yeah, how you can get some salt?
Are we done with this yet, or... Peek a sweetheart. She's 16 months. And she absolutely loved the ocean. She couldn't eat enough of the sand. she was actually laying down on her tummy with her hands and her toes getting worked into the sand, trying to nestle her face in and going, ooh.
Did mommy? Mommy, do you like the ocean today? What's Cece do?
What did Cece do? Cece went and she was laying down on the beach and smoothing her hands into it and their little feet and like, ooh, and then the waves were crashing up. She choked for a minute and then, oh, it was so fun. Well, she'd say that, but she was, go back, you know. I had her in a life jacket, so I just kept hanging onto the handle. I was like, what?
Yeah,
no. No, it's the front. Except one time she got.
Hey, don't break the knee.
I know, that's what I practiced.
Okay.
Okay.
Perfect.
Thank you. Hey. My mom and dad wanted to get on the camera together.
We were actually both on the same thing.
Really?
Give Paul playing peekaboo in the curtains. It's so cute.
This is Ocean City. Fine. It's our hotel. Our rooms are up there on the fourth floor on that balcony there. It's Atlantic City. I know, Ocean City. The big ones are way down there.
walk in and find out. 50 cents each. They could go if Claudia was willing to skip dessert that afternoon. Jamie added,
you know, you can't have your cake and take tours, too.
How about having tours and hot fudge sundaes, too? Claudia asked. They stood in line and got tickets for a tour. The girl selling tickets smiled down at them. No school today? She asked casually.
No, Jamie answered. The boiler on the furnace broke. No heat. They had to dismiss school. You sir heard the explosion. All the windows rattled. We thought it was an earthquake. 14 kids got cut and abrasions, and their parents are suing the school to pay for their medical expenses. Well, it was about 10 in the morning. We had just finished our spelling lesson when the man behind me.
How is it here?
Beautiful day by the ocean. Ocean City.
Look at Coco.
I hope you don't.
My tongue are curly.
Yeah, I tell you. Ouch. Get him off back. Feet on the ground there, Paul.
Where's Mary? Is that out there?
Power of nature. We got a lot of wind from the northeast today, and the waves are coming in.